Do you find yourself going back and forth from your Clipper-powered 3D printer to your computer to input commands? I do. I do this all the time. It's annoying as hell, and I want to fix it. Today, I'm going to show you how I built this little shortcut board for my 3D printer. I'm going to try and keep this as simple as possible, so it's easy to follow along. This is really a two-part project, but the two parts are so intertwined that it doesn't make sense to separate them. The first part is programming a secondary microcontroller for your printer. It's way easier than I expected. And the second part is adding inputs to that controller. Before I get too far, all of the parts for this project were provided to me for free by DF Robot. I told them the parts I wanted and they sent them over. They got no say in the project and they'll see the video when I post it. For the controller, I'm gonna be using the Beetle RP2040. It's basically an 8-pin clone of the Raspberry Pi Pico and it's perfect for this project. For the inputs, I am going to be using these gravity push buttons from DF Robot. They even light up. And for an additional output, I'm going to be adding these RGB LEDs, also from DF Robot, just for a little bit of spice. To get started, I designed this case and printed it off. I used ASA because I plan to install this inside my enclosure, which can get pretty toasty, and I don't want any issues with PLA. With that on the printer, let's move on to getting the microcontroller set up to be able to connect to Clipper. I'm going to assume you already set up your printer's main board, so we can skip a few steps in the Clipper docs and go straight into CDing into the Clipper directory. I'm connecting to the Pi using PuTTY, but I just learned you can also use PowerShell, which is built right into Windows. Once we're in the right directory, enter the command make menu config. Then out of these options, change the architecture to RP2040 and leave the rest alone. Now type in make, and you should see some stuff like this. It'll take a few minutes, but once it's done, you'll notice this file name here. Now I just need to get that file from the Pi to the computer I'm working on. I'm using WinSCP to get access to the file system on the Pi. Just navigate to the folder you noted from PowerShell and copy that file to your computer. I put it in my downloads folder. Connect the microcontroller to your computer while holding down the boot button. And it should show up like this. Drag the file you just got onto it, and it should eject itself. Unplug it from your computer and plug it into your Clipper Pi. Back in PuTTY, run the command ls /dev/serial/by-id/*. This will give you a list of all the USB devices on your printer. It'll be the one with RP2040 in the name. I'll pop it in Notepad just for ease of use. We'll need it later. With the firmware set up, let's move on to the mechanical assembly of the project. The mechanical assembly is pretty straightforward. To install the buttons, I'm using these mounted bosses I designed into the case, and I'm just putting two M3 screws in each button. The M3 screws will thread right into the plastic. I'm going to use the wire harnesses provided on these switches to connect everything, but I think if you wanted, you could use these pogo points on the back to solder to. For the LEDs, I ran the wire harness through this hole in the top, and then pulled off the sticky back that's provided on the LED strip. I then just used hot glue to press it all down. When I got around to the end, I measured out where I roughly wanted it to end, and just clipped it with a pair of wire cutters, and hot glued it in place. I cut a small piece of protoboard to connect to the ground and 3.3 volt pins. just so that I have enough connections for all of the buttons. To do this, I took a section of headers and just pulled out the pin in the center. Then I can solder the protoboard to the pins and the pins to the MCU. With that set, I roughly measured out the length of wire I needed for each button. Clipped off the DuPont connector, stripped the wires back, connected the ground and VCC pins, and then connected the signal pin to one of the input pads on the controller. I did not add a hard mounting boss for this MCU because until DF Robot reached out, I had actually planned on using the Raspberry Pi Pico. Before I close at the bottom, I just plug in the USB-C cord to the Beetle and run the cord out this little notch. I designed these little labels and added some text so that I can tell what every button does and I don't have to just memorize it. I printed those off in white PLA and then just went over the top with a Sharpie. I guess if you had a fancy pants multi-material machine, you could do a color swap. I'll provide a blank one and you can just use the text tool in Prusa Slicer or Orga Slicer to deboss whatever text you need on top. To put those in place, I just used a little bit of hot glue. And now we can move on to getting the code set up in Clipper. I know watching people program is boring, so I'm going to give a brief summary here, and then you can check out the full details in the linked instructional, as well as grab the full code. Basically, what I'm going to do is create a new .cfg file for this microcontroller. I'll put in the serial ID I got earlier up the top to define the controller, and then I'll set up all the buttons as G-code buttons with the G-code commands I want for each macro attached to them. Then for the LEDs, I just set it up like any other LED with a default color and brightness. One thing I noticed about these LEDs, if you turn them up to full brightness, they will draw too much power from the USB port on the Pi and cause everything to crash. So be careful with that. This could be fixed by using a separate 5-volt power supply, but I'm too lazy for that. And that's pretty much it. Let's check out how it works.
So I've got some PETG in now. I'm just gonna go ahead and preheat it to 230. Wait a few minutes. And now I can go ahead, pull this out and then put the PLA back in. So that's what I need to print next. Pull that out. Got my sea green here. Almost out. Go ahead and extrude it, change the color. Getting a little bit of blue out there, sea green out there. I can't quite see on camera, I bet. Not really. Let's do 50 more just to be sure. All the PETG is out, otherwise it'll do weird stuff, right? Seems good. Looks good to me. Sea green on the out. Let's go ahead and what is my Z offset at? It's a little high, so let's go ahead and adjust it down. Cause I know it's gonna have to go down a little bit and let's go ahead and start print. Let's go ahead and pause. There we go. Pause, move forward, resume, get back at it. And then go ahead whenever, really. Pause again. Go ahead and cancel print. Everything shuts down, temperature's turning off, hot end's cooling down, should be all good.
Like I mentioned, all of this will be on Instructables, and I'll put all the models up on Printables. Go check those out. Also, go follow me over on Instagram. I'm way more active there. Okay, bye.